Hi, this is Monir Uddin Ahmed, talking from Bangladesh, from the capital of Bangladesh, Dhaka City. I have bachelor and master degree in microbiology and then master degree in biotechnology, and I did my PhD in microbiology from Australia.
What is so interesting about microbiology?
Microbiology is very interesting because we are dealing organism that is not visible by our naked eye. We need microscope. But these very tiny organisms, they are very smart, they are very powerful, and they mostly cause benefit to human and other animals and plants, and very few cause diseases, but still we are more concerned about their harmful effect. That is the interesting part.
What kind of positive effects do these microorganisms have?
Microorganisms, they are ubiquitous and they have positive role in every sphere of our life. Microorganisms usually live in our body. We call them normal flora. They prevent pathogenic microorganisms to colonize in our body. They prevent them from attack our body in under normal condition. By occupying space, fighting for food, and many other things. And some microorganisms even provide us with vitamins.
What was the topic of your dissertation?
My PhD was in the area of food safety with microorganism called Campylobacter jejuni. That is one of the most frequently encountered microbial pathogen, bacterial pathogen in food industry, especially milk, water, and meat. So globally, it causes very large number of infection every year.
So you wrote that you want to make life better by making food better, right?
Yeah, because we cannot live without food. So if foods are safer, then our life becomes safer. And we have to make food safe from microorganisms, bacteria, especially bacterial pathogens, because they can easily get into foods. This is a global public health problem. It's a problem of developing countries. It's a problem in developed countries. For example, Australia and New Zealand had highest number of Campylobacter infection in the world. Both of them are developed countries. But in our countries, we have a little bit different problem. In developed countries, it's problem from meat mostly. In developing countries like us, water, milk, and my research interest was in the finding the source of infection. If we can find the sources of infection, then we can find measures how can we prevent them from entering into foods.
And you also initiated a science magazine.
Yeah, I have started a science magazine. It's online only and it's bilingual. And I would say that it's the only serious science magazine in Bangladesh. We want to talk more about the policy level, and we want to review how our research organizations are performing. Since 2011, we are publishing a review of science publications in our Bangladesh. How many science articles are published from Bangladesh, and which organization is at the top, and which scientist is at the top.
What is the purpose of this magazine?
I'm dreaming about developed Bangladesh. The theme of our Scientific Bangladesh magazine is Science Review for Developed Bangladesh. Actually, our vision or mission, whatever you say, we said that Science Review for Developed Bangladesh. We want to see Bangladesh as a developed country, and we believe that reviewing scientific performance of Bangladesh government, non-government organizations, we can contribute much in that field.
How relevant is research for a developing country like Bangladesh, in your opinion?
For every country, research is relevant because research means finding a solution to a problem. In a country, especially a developing country like Bangladesh, which is highly populated, overcrowded, so we have more problem in comparison to other countries. We have different problems. So we have to find our own solution to those problems, be it social problem, be it microbiological problem, be it physical science problem, or whatever it is. So to reduce the problems, to make our life better, healthier, prosperous. Actually, we don't have alternative way other than research.
How relevant is research for a developing country like Bangladesh?
Scientists have the same role in both in developed and developing countries. They have to play a dual role. One is working in the laboratory, finding the solution of the problem of their national and global problem, and communicate that solution to mass people, to other scientists, and to the policymakers. By playing this dual role, I think scientists can really bring changes. If they don't emphasize on both type of roles, I think it's very difficult to bring any changes in the society or in the country. Because there are lots of solutions or findings sitting in the laboratory, they are not commercialized or communicated to the people or to the policymakers.
What are the main challenges that researchers are facing in Bangladesh?
First of all, lacking of enough funding. Secondly, I would say we have issues with leadership in scientific area. Thirdly, we have lackings in infrastructure, technological side. We have issues with lab facilities, instruments for laboratories, and consumables for laboratories. So these are three main areas we have to make improvement.
What should or could be done in order to improve the situation?
I think we have to focus both on improving the technical facilities in the laboratory and leadership skills of the scientists equally. Because we might have technical facilities all, but if we don't have the leadership to run the laboratory smoothly, properly, we cannot utilize the fund properly and technical facilities. The limited facilities that we have, still we cannot utilize that one. Our efficiency of utilization, I would not say that is more than 50%. Because we have poor leadership everywhere, especially particularly in the scientific area. So if we can improve leadership, this way we can make better use of our space, of our money, and of our human resources, of our intelligence, merit, whatever you say. So without focusing on that area, we cannot improve. Actually, whatever area we are talking, be it politics, be it outside politics and science, improvement or progress is proportional to the quality of leadership.
What does leadership mean to you?
In a word, leadership is influence. And I have my own definition of leadership because that's my area of interest. And I'm writing a book about leadership in Bangla. So my definition is leadership is influencing people to act to achieve goal. So whenever scientist is working, they have a goal to achieve that goal, they have to influence other scientists to work, because research cannot be done alone. Actually, hardly anything can be done alone.
In your opinion, what does a researcher need in order to become a good leader?
So, first point, communication skill. Second point, specific goal setting, what I want to do and by when. So if we don't have any goal, we can have many things, we will not actually go anywhere. And third point that is important, that we want to contribute for humanity throughout the world. Because if we can find any solution to a problem, that will be used throughout the world. That will not be limited to any specific area or any country, though we might try, sometimes we try to restrict the technology, but it's very difficult. So scientific discovery by anyone, any scientist of any race, color, and nationalities, actually that is the asset of the humanity in the world. So we have to think about that one, that I'm making contribution for the humanity, and it has a long-lasting impact.
If you had all the money and the power you can imagine, and you could change something, what would you change?
I would like to do something that will have impact generation after generation. So I'll increase the investment in research and education, because it is said investment for self-development is the best investment for individual and as a nation is same. So I'll invest that money on development of people. That means their especially psychological and intellectual development, because that will affect. In other words, single word, I can say I'll invest that one for leadership development, every single people of the country or world.
What motivates you?
Actually, motivation is that as a Muslim, we believe we have life after death, and there is two options: either we are going to heaven or hell. So it depends on our activities. There are two types. One is worshipping God or Allah. That will be finished when I'm dying. But if I do anything for humanities that is impacting life of human, I will get benefit from that one. So people might not be aware what I am doing or how my work is impacting their life, but it will continue. That is called in our religious language, that is sadqa-e jariya. That means your charity that will continue even after your death. So I see it this way. This is the driving force behind trying to bring changes or influencing life of people.
What kind of society do you dream of?
I have a dream of a just society where everyone will be treated with justice, because without justice we cannot have peace and prosperity.
What would you tell a teenager in Bangladesh who would like to become a researcher?
First, I would say to a teenager, try to know your field of interest, find your interest, be it social science, political science, even natural science, and then focus to solve people problem in people's life, because there is no more contentment than solving problem for people. So if you really want to enjoy that contentment, then you can be a researcher.
Thank you so much, Monir.
Thank you, Narina, calling from Sweden and giving me opportunity to share my ideas, experience, and convey my message to people, politicians, and teenagers in my country. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Monir.